we go, guys. Welcome to the top 10 most anticipated comics for February 8th, 2023. Guys, I'm Mike Spider Slayer. Welcome back to the channel. It's never too early to start that pull list for next week because hopefully this list helps you make decisions on what comic books to buy. Before we dive into it, guys, I gotta give a quick shout out to Whatnot. It's the free downloadable app where you can bid on anything that you want, whether it's comics, cards, Legos, Hot Wheels, anything. And I'm gonna give you a link in my description box below where you can save $15 off of your first purchase. And yeah, that's all it is. It's super easy. I'm giving you $15. Just download that link, create a profile today, and you'll be set to go. So don't forget about Whatnot. All right, guys, so here we go. Diving it in to the hot seat book of the week. And this one goes to Storm and the Brotherhood of Mutants. This is issue one, the spin-off series from the Sins of Sinister book. I can honestly tell you that Sins of Sinister issue one was actually a really good read. And it kind of got you caught up of what's going on and Mr. Sinister's diabolical plan to take over the world and whatnot. And now we're going to get these spin-off titles. And this one has to do with Storm. Storm has been a major player in this particular series. And I am on the fence about it, honestly, because once again, we don't know how these spin-off books are going to be, if they're going to be worth reading or whatnot. But again, Storm is a major player. She wants revenge for what Mr. Sinister has done. So we're going to see what happens with that. Looking forward to it. 28 pages, $4. But if issue 2 is bad, I'm not going to be reading it. All right, so what's the book that's on the rise? Well, we have Gangsta Ass Barista, issue 2. This one's written by Patrick Shand, and this is a wonderful book about this female that's got this hidden past, right, that works at this coffee shop like a Starbucks. This guy comes in with money one day, where a bag, mystery bag of money. These two got into a fight with each other. He lost his money. Our barista, she finds the freaking the bag full of money, and now she's trying to keep it for herself. And there's people after the money. The character Trinity, though, is a delight. She is an awesome character to read, and I love the first issue. A little bit heavy on the dialogue, but I never felt bored by it, so I can't wait to see how the story continues. This is a $5 comic book. So now we move on to our 10th spot. And I've always enjoyed Daredevil, but it's always a little slow before it gets going. But I feel like now is the time where it's getting going. And this is Daredevil issue 8. And the description that it gives when you read the synopsis is At Last War. This is legacy numbering 656. It's a 28 page comic. It's $4. Our heroes here have teamed up. Elektra and Daredevil, they're like husband and wife for the Fist, and now you got the Hand, and it looks like they're going to do this crazy ass battle with each other, and it looks like Punisher's involved as well. That's going to be a lot of fun. Can't wait for it, guys. Number 9, we're going to see how this goes. We're going to get a couple of Spidey spin-off books. The first one here is Red Goblin. Eventually we're going to get the Hallow's Eve book. Red Goblin issue 1 is a mini-series. It has to do with Norman Osborn's grandson, Normie Osborn. In past issues, he was the Red Goblin, and now he's going to be the Red Goblin again. And how is he going to react? Is he going to be a good guy? Is he going to be a bad guy? He's going to go through almost the same struggles as his grandfather, right? Like what he's going through in the Gold Goblin series. He's a Red Goblin again because of Dylan Brock. He recruits him to try to stop Bedlam. So, I don't know. That's obviously spinning off the pages of Dark Web. We'll see what happens. 36 pages, $5. Coming in at number 8. This is a series that has been definitely under the radar. I don't hear too many people talking about it. This is Secret Invasion issue 1. This whole story has to deal with Maria Hill and Tony Stark. And Tony Stark has this weird plan of actually having the Skrulls be on his side. And he feels that not every Skrull is a villain, they're just soldiers of the overall leaders. But if he can have them work with him and the people on Earth, they can be a valuable asset. And in this story, Maria Hill doesn't kind of agree with that. And in the last issue, she kind of goes balls to the walls on these Skrulls. And now Tony Stark looks like he's going to be going AWOL here. This is definitely, like I said, an underrated series. I definitely would check it out. This is issue 4. I don't know how many issues there are. I think there's 6. But yeah, good book, guys. 28 pages, $4. Moving on to number 7. We begin a new story arc here. This is Ghost Rider issue 11, Hellfire and Danny Ketch. So not only have we had Johnny Blaze in this book, but we're also going to get Danny Ketch, and he was introduced very briefly in the very last page of Ghost Rider issue 10. Now, I don't think he's the same. I think he's being brainwashed, kind of how Johnny Blaze was in the very first issue of this series. And I'm curious to see how these two are going to interact. Are they going to fight? Like, this has been a phenomenal series written by Benjamin Percy, very horrific, gory-like. So if you've loved this series so far from the beginning, I say continue reading it. And if you're looking for a jumping on point, might be a good jumping on point. I don't know, but I would definitely recommend reading the first 10 issues to get the tone of the series. So this is Legacy numbering 254, 28 pages, $4 comic. Coming in at number 6, we have Joe Fixit. This is issue 2. It's been a hot minute, I feel like, since this issue has come out. Maybe because I enjoyed the first one so much. But we have Joe Fixit that's in charge of this territory, our casino, and Kingpin is going after him to try to stop him. And let's just say Kingpin kind of failed at all levels that's trying to stop Joe Fixit. But I don't think he really realized that it was the Hulk. In fact, no one realizes it's the Hulk because he's gray and he's smart, right? Spider-Man's along for the ride because Spider-Man wants to know what Kingpin is up to. There's some comical moments in this comic as well, especially the very last page of issue 1. Definitely suggest Joe Fixit, especially if you're an old school Hulk guy and you're a Peter David fan. This is 28 pages, $4. Moving on to number 5, we have Gold Goblin. This is issue 4, the bright spot of Dark Web. Like I said earlier when it came to the Red Goblin series, how Normie has to, you know, make a decision if he's going to be good or bad. This is what Gold Goblin has been about being good or bad, anti-hero or whatnot. And I don't know, we're going to have to see, I think, Norman at some kind of crossroads where he's going to make a decision. And I think he's gonna cross the line. He's gonna become Green Goblin once again. But for right now, I like him being a good guy. It's not too bad. And he's teamed up with the Jack-O-Lantern, which seems what happened at the end of the last issue. But it's been a fun ride, man, seeing this kind of redemption story for him, trying to deal with guilt. It's an emotion that he's never had before. And again, it's been the bright spot of the Dark Web. That and Black Cat, and that's really about it. 28 pages, $4. Coming in at number 4, we have a solid story here. Batman and the Deadly Duo. This is book 4. You gotta love and appreciate the artwork and the story here by Mark Silvestri. It's absolutely brilliant. The detective work is amazing, and that's something that I feel like we have not seen so much in Batman stories as of late. And I love this story of trying to figure out where this DNA is coming from that produces all these clone-like Jokers. And I love how Batman has finally accepted to team up here with the Joker so they can do battle and find this guy and rescue Harley. I am so looking forward to seeing how this whole story continues. Again, the artwork in this book is amazing, and it's like you gotta flip through it a couple of times in order to really appreciate it. 32 pages, $5. Coming in at number 3, you might be a little bit surprised because I wasn't a fan of the last issue, but you always got to be excited for it. And it's Batman issue 132. This is titled The Batman of Gotham Part 2. slash the Toy Box Part 2. So there's two stories here, and they do connect with each other. So the Batman Man of Gotham story is the story that continues off of the Failsafe story arc, where he basically is, in Failsafe's eyes, is dead, but wind up getting transported to a different Earth. And in this Earth, Batman is not dead. Batman is dead, and now he got transported to this Earth. And all of these different villains or Batman's rogues gallery kind of play a little bit of a different role. So it's similar but different, right? We've seen that story before, and I was kind of upset about that in the last issue because it just felt like nothing new. And I like stuff continuing in main Earth. I don't like when we got to go to a different Earth because I just feel like it's a little bit of a cop-out. We'll see where it goes. I have faith in Chip Zdarsky's writing. He's written some phenomenal stuff. And then the second story has to deal with Tim Drake actually trying to find Batman. And he knows he's not dead. He knows he's somewhere else. So I like that. I like how that backup story actually connects. And it makes you feel like it's worth your money, right? So it's 40 pages, and that one is $5. Coming in at number two, here we go. The Amazing Spider-Man, issue 19. The dark web is over, but the effects will shake Spider-Man forever. Come on, man. There's nothing that happened in this book. He was never threatened, right? But here we go. I'm really excited about this issue because I want to see how this is written, okay? There's a team up here between Black Cat and Spider-Man. Now, the creative team is completely different on this book, and I think it's for this story arc. We have writer Joe Kelly and artist Terry Dodson here. Terry Dodson's a great artist, and I love when he draws Black Cat. A+ in my book. I want to see what Joe Kelly can do here and see what kind of story he can put together. I know it's only a short story. It's not the overall arcing thing, but I'm looking forward to something different and something exciting. And whenever Spider-Man can team up with Black Cat in a battle or team up, whatever it is, it's awesome. So I'm definitely looking forward to this. Legacy numbering 913, 28 pages, $4. So after number one, we're now done, guys, as we're going to be talking about those noteworthy comics, some of the books that are not mentioned on my top 10 most anticipated, but I'm letting you know they exist because you might want to pick them up. And this week's number one most anticipated, once again, guys, goes to The Flash, issue 792, The 1 Minute War. This is part three. You know, this book is awesome. I said this when I talked about this book in my poll. This book just reminds me of like why I fell in love with comics. It's not a complex story, right? It's not something that tries to go outside of its means. It's a story that's got nice balance between the characters, the action, the plot, and a great cliffhanger. And sometimes the simplicity is all you need. And when I was younger, yes, that's how I got into comics. So it kind of reminds me of why I got into comics in the first place. And sometimes we don't get enough of those simplistic books anymore. We always get books with these complex plots and these plots that go on for years and years and years. And sometimes all you need is a four-issue, five-issue little story arc with a self-contained event that has nothing better than some aliens coming over to take the world. You know, it's just a fun book, and that's all I can say about it, with great artwork. And I love the Flash family. I love how they interact with each other. I love the emotion in there because we have a death that's going on right now, whether that sticks or not. It's still yet to be determined, but it's a great read, and I look forward to it every single time it comes out, right? So that's all I gotta say about it. Really easy. 32 pages, $4. All right, so here we go for some of the noteworthy books that you guys might want to pick up this particular comic book week. The first one goes to The Joker, The Man Who Stopped Laughing, issue 5. Isn't that the book where the Joker had a clay baby or something? It's weird. Then we have Gotham City, year 1, issue 5. I hear nothing but good things about this series. Then we have the continuation of the Lazarus Planet one-shots. This is Next Evolution. This is issue 1. Want to know in the comments below if you guys are continuing with those one-shots. Moving on to Marvel Comics, we have the Avengers War Across Time, issue 2. I love the first issue of this. However, it just seemed it was a little too long for what it was trying to accomplish. But I say, don't pass this up. Pick this book up, guys. It's a fun Avengers read. Then we have an interesting book here. This is called Bishop War College, issue 1, as we have the X-Men as they're all bishops. I'm so curious what that story is going to be about. So I'm going to check that one out for sure. Then we move on to the indies. Of course, we have Spawn issue 338. Then we have a new book from Boom. Going back to the horror side of things. Harrower issue 1, if I said that wrong. Or right, I don't know. And then we have The Exiled, issue 1. This is that new Wesley Snipes book. So you guys might want to put that on your list as well. So guys, there you have it. There are my top 10 and noteworthy comic books getting ready to come out for February 8th, 2023. So hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Now speaking of top 10, here's my top 10 comic book covers of the week where you can vote on your favorite comic book cover. And of course, guys, as always, keep buying, keep collecting, but most importantly, always read those comics, and guys, I'll see you tomorrow, which is New Comic Book Day.